Welcome to the BCN3D Epsilon Configuration Assistant. The first step will be installing the printing surface. In order to install the printing surface, slightly tilt it and insert it in the back clips. Make sure that it's in all the way. Then lower the printing surface and fix it with the side clips. It's very important to make sure that the printing surface is correctly centered and touching the back clips. Make sure that it's in all the way. Note that it's normal to have a gap between the printing surface and the front flanges. The clips should always be fully closed in order to avoid collisions with other components of the printer. Choose your preferred language and press continue. In order to register your printer, you have to connect it to the internet. You can connect your BCN3D Epsilon by Ethernet cable or using the Wi-Fi dongle, both of which you will find in the toolkit. For a fast and reliable connection, connect the Ethernet cable and the printer will connect to your network automatically. If you don't have an Ethernet port available nearby, you can use the Wi-Fi dongle. Once it's connected, you will be able to select your network and type the password to connect. Once it's connected, press continue. The next step will be registering your printer. With the BCN3D Cloud, you'll be able to use your printer regardless of your location. In order to register your BCN3D Epsilon, scan the QR code or copy the website's URL appearing on the screen. Fill out the registration form and click on Register Your Printer. The printer will automatically stay connected to your personal BCN3D Cloud account. In order to load the filament into your printer, start by installing the spool holders. On the screen, select the extruder and the material you are loading in and wait until the hot end reaches the indicated temperature for the selected material. Open the spool and cut the end of the filament at a 45-degree angle. Install the spool in the correct position and insert the filament into the filament entry hole. Keep pushing the filament in. You will feel resistance as it passes through the filament runout sensor, which allows the printer to detect whenever it runs out of material. You can see how the loading option is enabled as soon as the sensor detects the filament. Continue pushing the filament until you notice that it has arrived at the extruder. To finish, press continue and push the filament slightly in until the extruder has started to load the material. In case the extruder was not able to load the material, please cut the end of the filament again in the opposite direction and repeat the process. Once the printer has finished the loading process, you can keep pressing the load button until you see the material is coming out of the nozzle uniformly. Repeat the process with the other extruder. If it's necessary, you can also load the filament from the back of the printer. This loading point was developed with the 2.3kg spools in mind. Because of their size, they cannot be loaded from the inside of the printer. First, attach the external spool holder. This piece can be 3D printed with any type of printer, and you can find a link to download the STL file in the video description or in the printed parts article, which you can find in the BCN3D knowledge base on our website. Then place the spool on the spool holder and cut the end of the filament at 45 degrees. Lastly, insert the end of the filament into the rear loading point. Printer calibration is essential in order to obtain good quality prints. It's very important to calibrate your printer correctly, especially after transporting it. We also recommend to carry out this process frequently as part of the printer's regular maintenance. To begin, verify that the printing surface is correctly installed. Then you can start the printer calibration assistant. First, wait until the print surface reaches the indicated temperature. Each of the hot ends will carry out a series of measurements in order to establish the print surface position. Afterwards, through the printer calibration assistant on the screen, you will be guided through the necessary adjustments needed to complete the print surface leveling. Turn the two front knobs according to the instructions appearing on the screen, and to finish, select Redo in order for the printer to verify the adjustments made. The printer's calibration assistant establishes the distance between the nozzle and the print surface in the Z-axis, as well as the distance between the left and right hot ends in the X and Y-axis. The first calibration process will adequately adjust the nozzle height in the Z-axis, allowing the material to be extruded correctly and to adhere to the platform. First, the left hot end will be calibrated. Press Calibrate in order to begin the process, and the printer will start to heat up the hot end. Use a piece of paper to clean the hot end. Apply a fine and unified layer of Magigou glue to the entire print surface. Use the calibration gauge included in the toolkit to adjust the offset between the nozzle and the print surface. Move the gauge back and forth without pressing on the print surface, and at the same time, keep checking on the rising platform until you notice some resistance. If you raise the platform too high, the gauge will flex. If so, then you need to lower the platform until the gauge can slide again, but still with some resistance from the nozzle. Select Accept. The printer will start to create 5 calibration lines from right to left. Each line will be more adhered to the print surface than the previous one. You can take the print surface out to examine the calibration lines. You can also touch them to feel the thickness of each sample. If the nozzle and the printing surface are too close, the material won't extrude completely. If they are too far apart, the material will be deposited unevenly and won't adhere correctly to the printing surface. A proper calibration allows the filament to come out smoothly from the nozzle and to be well adhered to the printing surface. Select the most uniform and adhered line and choose it on the printer's touchscreen. If none of the calibration lines are correct, or if some of them are not correctly adhered to the print surface, you can repeat the printing pattern again, or even repeat the calibration process with the gauge. Repeat the process once more with the right hot end, and try to maintain the same amount of resistance as done with the left hot end. Use the same criteria and select a sample calibration line for the right hot end as well. Keep in mind that your selection doesn't need to be the same as the previously selected number. It may be necessary to install shims on one of the hot ends in order to mechanically correct the offset between the nozzles. This allows the printer to accurately print in both duplication and mirror mode, which create two parts at the same time. To learn how to install shims, follow the link in the description. The next step is to calibrate the distance between both hot ends in the X-axis, which will guarantee a perfect alignment between them and making sure that the layers will not shift. Select Continue and the printer will create a new set of lines with both of the hot ends. From left to right, choose the pair of lines that is best aligned and select it on the touchscreen. Calibrate the Y-axis in the same way. This time from back to front, select the pair of lines that is perfectly aligned. Keep in mind that your selection doesn't need to be the same as the previously calibrated X-axis. Your printer is now perfectly calibrated and ready to print.